Change settings for Braille Viewer. Would you like to change the font style, point size, or foreground and background colors for Braille Viewer? Let's look at how to change these settings next. First, press Insert J to open the JAWS context menus.
JAWS context menu, run from tray menu.
Press U to open the Utilities submenu.
JAWS tandem submenu.
Press V, Victor, to select the Braille and Text Viewer submenu.
Braille and Text Viewer submenu, enable Braille Viewer checked.
Press down arrow to move to Settings and then press Enter.
Enable Text Viewer. Settings dot dot dot. Leaving menus, document dash WordPad, edit. Default left parent all applications, right parent dash JAWS Fusion Settings Center dialog, 3 view, level 1. General 3 items, Braille and Text Viewers.
Settings Center opens to the location for Braille and Text Viewer settings. Press down arrow.
Level 2, window settings closed, 1 of 3, General Braille and Text Viewers.
I'll press right arrow to open this.
Window settings open, 2 items.
Down arrow.
Level 3, position top of screen, 1 of 2, window settings, General Braille and Text Viewers.
You may press spacebar to toggle the position from the top of the screen to the bottom of the screen if desired. I'll press down arrow again.
Monitor unavailable, this setting is only available if more than one
If you have multiple monitor support, you may choose the monitor for Braille or Text Viewer to appear in. I'll press down arrow once more.
Level 2, font settings closed, 2 of 3, General Braille and Text Viewers.
Press right arrow to open this node.
Font settings open, 2 items.
Press down arrow.
Level 3, font Seco UI, 1 of 2, font settings, General Braille and Text Viewers.
There are 2 items here in the tree view, but there are several different fonts you can choose from, based on the fonts on your computer. I'll leave this as it is and press down arrow again.
Size 40.
I'll leave this as it is for now and continue to press down arrow.
Level 2, color settings closed, 3 of 3, General Braille and Text Viewers.
Press right arrow to open this node.
Color settings open, 8 items.
Press down arrow again.
Level 3, text color black, 1 of 8, color settings, General Braille and Text Viewers.
I'm going to set this to lime green for the foreground and black for the background. Press spacebar until you hear Fusion announce lime green.
White, Sev Custom, 18 of 18, purple, 6 of 8, fuchsia, 7 of 8, red, 8 of 8, orange, 9 of 8, yellow, 10 of 8, lime green, 11 of 18.
Okay, now press down arrow to move to background color, and then press spacebar to find black.
Custom color dot dot dot. Background color white. Drab, saddle brown, burly wood, fit black, 16 of 18.
There it is. Press enter to close Settings Center.
Document-WordPad, document-WordPad, edit.
The changes have taken place to the foreground and background color for Braille Viewer. Let me show you one more thing here. Focus is back in the document. I'll type in another sentence. I enjoy using the new Braille Viewer.
Bottom of file, hello, how are you today?
In the Braille Viewer, I can see the text I just wrote, but focus is at the end of the line. I want to show you how to use layered commands to pan left or right on the Braille display. First, press Insert Spacebar to open the layered commands. Now, press V, Victor.
Braille and Text Viewer.
And now you may press left arrow to pan the display to the left. Now I see the beginning of the line. I'll press right arrow to pan to the right. If there were more text available, I could also press up or down arrow to pan one line up or down at a time. For now, I'll close the Braille Viewer. First, press Escape to get out of layered mode. Then, go back into layered mode by pressing Insert Spacebar, then V, Victor, followed by B, Bravo.
Braille and Text Viewer. Disabling the Braille Viewer.
Thanks for joining me for this demonstration of the Braille Viewer, now available in both JAWS and Fusion.
Freedom Scientific, of the Sparrow brand. give this video a like and be sure to subscribe to our channel. Have questions, feedback, or suggestions for future training for the FS training team? Send an email to training@vespero.com. To stay up to date on upcoming webinars and training events, complete the sign-up form at freedomscientific.com/webinars. Thanks again for connecting with us.